The dominant educational model often implicitly supports the ruling value system. It is the dominant perspective. Thus, schools which produce well-adjusted citizens and well-rounded individuals are in fact producing individuals which are adjusted to the flaws and presuppositions of that society. As Jiddu Krishnamurti put it, it is no measure of health to be well-adjusted to a profoundly sick society. At the same time, the place of systems of knowledge, learning and research and inquiry must stand at the forefront of such a society if we're able to gather such feedback in a cohesive, meaningful way. If we are to progress, these systems must be open and freely available for all to access. The issues we see in the stories we've discussed and what we see in the world come from restricted access, from blocking and compartmentalizing pre-existing areas of culture or of information. This, if we are able to progress, must be overthrown. And if you think about it, there is no actual way of successfully cooperating and working together if we continue the practice of ownership, because ownership presupposes non-cooperation. There is already a value program, an attitude, a practice that fits this bill. With the necessity of proof, testing, self-awareness, and self-critical analysis, the scientific method is the method by which we can serve and update our society. Its reference are in the physical world, not the opinion of some politician, nor the folkways of industry, nor the traditions of a religion. As you look around in this room, I'd ask you to become mindful of the things which the scientific method has actually given us. My voice is audible. I have something called slides, which underline my point. We sit on and in constructed edifices and wear clothes that are all the result of technical processes. Indeed, many of us are alive because of science. Had I been born with medical technology set back 100 years, I would most likely not be speaking to you today. Now, it must be made clear that the scientific method is not the same as some elements of the modern scientific establishment. Indeed, the horrors, inefficiencies, slowness to adapt, and other attributes previously mentioned are the results of the interference of the dominant cultural value set with the attempts of the scientific method. The results are systematically downgraded and diluted scientific landscape. If the scientific method were the act of running, we are currently running underwater. Rather, it is the system attributes of the scientific method themselves that, when promoted to the overriding value orientation of society, will yield a system where efficiency and sustainability are promoted and where the obsolescence and waste-generating mechanism of present-day life are deselected in favor of those processes that take care of every human being well beyond what we would believe actually possible in a market system based on competition, inefficiency, tradition, so on. Many people consider this to be cold and unfeeling. Well, if using science to solve our social issues sounds cold to you, you may want to consider this. You employ the scientific method every day. Placing one foot in front of the other will enable you to walk forwards. Having learned this, and that it's generally a good idea to face forward, you employ this method because of the results you have come to get from that. You know that turning a door handle and either pushing or pulling the door will enable you to pass through. Nobody attempts to simply walk through a closed door because of the environmental feedback from testing it that has resulted in the proven knowledge that it is an unsuccessful practice and the cause of many, many headaches, at least for me. The most metaphysically orientated minds will still interact with the physical world in the way that the human body requires and is able to. It is a physical referent in that sense that drives every action. This is why we propose a resource-based economy. Money is not scientific. It's made up. It no longer works as a positive force in society. Instead, dividing, blocking, and usurping human ingenuity that has been present since the absence of money as a motivational force. Tesla didn't do it for the money. Armstrong wasn't a radio genius since his teens because of the money. Galileo didn't do it for the money. Martin Luther King didn't do it for the money. If you're only doing it for the money, it's probably not worth doing to begin with. Okay? Using what science and technology can truly offer us, we will evolve beyond the need for money. And with it, we will free ourselves from the inefficiencies, debt, slavery, and tendencies towards manipulation that the present system's faulty self-analysis puts down to human nature and the way things are. In fact, we're already evolving beyond the need for money anyway, or at least our ability to maintain it usefully within society. We have in the last 50 years automated phone operators, while massively increasing phone operator services. We have automated bank teller positions, and you're telling me we're taking less money out now? People actually forget there is even once a job called a bank teller, and were those guys, those token ones in Barclays, not there anymore, you would forget it immediately because they're not necessary. We've got rid of the lift operator. He doesn't exist anymore. Nor does the Iceman, thanks to the refrigerator. Blockbuster and similar stores are basically going out of business because of online DVD services, largely automated, as are entirely automated DVD machines. This alone will do away with the entire concept of money, a system which is now resulting in poorly applied technologies, stunted innovation, death and destruction, not to mention the social ills of poverty, crime, and gaming for advantage. In a society based on the scientific method, applied for social concern, we do away with vague human opinion in the operation of society. I don't care what David Sarnoff may think of FM technologies or what a large pharmaceutical company thinks about Stanislav Brzezinski's treatment of cancer. If the science works, it stays. If it is one day surpassed by better methods, it goes. End of. No politicians, no voting, no straw polls, no vox pop interviews with people who do not know what the fuck they're talking about. It is the election of ideas that we're in desperate need of, if we are to survive in the most abundant, enjoyable, safe, free and fair society we can possibly create at any given moment. And I will just say about that freedom. This is one of the big things that we're going to face, is you're affecting my freedom with your new system. Okay, you don't have any freedom whatsoever other than laws of nature. Sorry, that's the way it goes. And any society that affords you new freedoms, it's because of the architecture of that society. Not something that was written down on an old piece of paper that people pay money to go and see, or any of that rubbish. It's the architecture of the society you're in, okay? Just remember that, because people are going to bring it up to you all the time. And if science has taught us anything, it has taught us that working together is better than working alone or against each other. We can be so wonderfully achieving were the world simply to stop, look around, assess the situation, look at our tools, take stock of what resources are left and where, and fight the common enemy. And the enemy we all face now is what our culture is doing to us. It's the stage we are setting for our own destruction. Should we not reform our society and base it on resource management enabled through the scientific tools that we have? These are our three limiters. The market itself is the determiner of the options you see in society. The forces of profit, competition, and ownership. The mind lock, our second limiter, blocks our ability to assess our market lock, the way things are, within a wider context, what Will would call a new frame. And our education, including the media and every other available source of information, informs both the ability to think and our ability to act on one side, and represents, promotes, and governs the discourse of the market on the other side in the form of propaganda. Combined, they are the overarching lock mechanism. They are the three bars on our prison cell window. Is it up there? Took me a while to find that. Many of them don't have three anymore. The social model we promote contravenes the need for these limiters, based on the understanding that strategically serving every human is to our individual and collective advantage by using our only proven tools, the scientific method, and our knowledge of technology. Everything else is just whistling past the graveyard.